to find the solution of one dimensional wave equation. We know that the one dimensional wave equation is dou square y by dou x square equal to 1 by c square into dou square y by dou t square. Say this is equation number 1. Here y is a dependent variable, x and t are independent variables. As explained in the method of separation of variables, the solution, trial solution of this equation is product of two functions. One is function of small x alone and another one is function of small t alone. Let y of x comma t is equal to x of x into t of t. Say this is equation number 2 be the trial solution of equation 1. Substituting equation 2 in equation 1, before that, where x is a function of x alone, capital T is a function of t alone, where x is a function of x alone and t that of small t alone. Now substituting equation 2 in equation 1. So we are substituting 2 in equation 1. We get here dou square y by dou x square, that is partially differentiating y with respect to x 2 times. We will get x double dash into t, since t is a constant while partially differentiating with respect to x. And here 1 by c square into dou square y by dou t square. So partially differentiating y with respect to t twice, keeping x as constant, we get x into t double dash. Now x double dash into capital T equal to 1 by c square into x into t double dash. Say now separating the variables. Since we are finding the solution by the method of separation of variables, now separating the variables, we will get x variables one side and t variables another side. So therefore, x double dash by capital X, we are writing x in the right hand side, we are writing it in the left hand side. Therefore, 1 by c square into t double dash, and the t which is in the left hand side, we are writing in the right hand side. Since in the left hand side, it is a multiplicative factor, therefore it will become in the denominator in the right hand side. Say this is a equation number 3. Since small x and small t are independent variables, equation 3 can only be true if each side is equal to the same constant. So we will say that it is a k. Since x and t are independent variables, therefore 3 can only be true if each side is equal to the same constant k. Say this is k. Therefore, assuming that x double dash by x equal to 1 by c square into t double dash by t equal to k. Now this can be written as x double dash by x is equal to k 1 by c square into t double dash by t is equal to k. Therefore, by cross multiplication, this can be written as x double dash equal to kx. Therefore, minus k into x is equal to 0. Here, this is t double dash by cross multiplication c square tk minus c square k into capital T equal to 0. Therefore, which is the ordinary differential equation where x dash is the second derivative of x with respect to x. Therefore, now this is d square x by dx square minus k into x equal to 0. This is d square t by dt square minus c square k into t equal to 0. Therefore, now put capital D is equal to d by dx. Then above equation can be written as equation becomes capital D square minus k into x, d square x minus kx. We are writing it as d square minus k of x equal to 0. Therefore, to find its solution, linear differential homogeneous equation, first write the auxiliary equation. Now auxiliary equation is d square minus k equal to 0. Here put d dash is equal to d by dt, then the above equation becomes capital D dash square minus C square K into T equal to 0. So we are writing this as a capital D dash square of T minus C square K into T. Therefore, we are writing it as D dash square minus C square K of T equal to 0. Therefore, to find its solution, since it is a linear ordinary differential equation with constant coefficients, auxiliary equation is d dash square minus c square k equal to 0. Now clearly the solution depends on the values of k. Here k may be positive or negative or 0. So we will discuss each case separately. When k is positive, k is negative, and k is a 0. We will discuss in detail case 1, case 2, and case 3 as a positive, negative, and a 0. The solutions of the equations depends on the values of k. Case 1, when k is positive and is equal to p square. For our convenience, we are assuming that k is equal to p square. Therefore, above equation can be written as d square minus k value, we are assuming that p square equal to 0. Therefore, from this d square equal to p square. Therefore, d equal to plus or minus p. So therefore the roots are real and distinct. The roots are real and distinct. And again, here also d dash square minus c square and k is equal to p square equal to 0. Therefore d dash square equal to c square p square. Therefore d dash is equal to plus or minus c into p. Since p is a k is positive value, here this is a square of the quantity, so c square into p square. Therefore plus or minus cp, real and distinct. The roots are real and distinct. Therefore the roots are real and distinct. Real and distinct. Therefore, solution is differential equation is y is equal to c1 e to the power of p into x, since x is the dependent variable, sorry, independent variable, y is dependent variable, plus c2 e to the power of minus px. Therefore, here the roots are real and distinct. We have the solution of the differential equation is y is equal to capital T. Here T is the dependent variable, small t is the independent variable. Therefore, this can be written as capital T is equal to RT of T is equal to C3, already C1, C2 used here, C3 e to the power of CPT plus C4 into e to the power of minus CPT. So this is the solution in case number 1. These are the solutions obtained in case 1. Now, substituting these two values x and t in y and t in equation number 2, we get the required solution of equation 1, that is one dimensional wave equation. Now, substituting the values of capital Y and capital T in equation 1, sorry, in equation 2, we get this is capital X. Y of x comma t is equal to x of x into t of t. Therefore, x is equal to c1. Here also x. C1 e to the power of px plus c2 e to the power of minus px into c3 e to the power of cpt plus c4 e to the power of minus cpt. This is the solution of the one dimensional wave equation in case 1. Next, case 2. When k is a negative and is equal to minus p square. For our convenience only, we are taking p square minus p square. Case 2. when k is negative and equal to minus p square, then the auxiliary equation becomes d square minus k equal to 0. That means d square plus minus of minus plus p square equal to 0. D dash square minus of minus plus c square into p square equal to 0. Therefore, d square minus of minus plus p square equal to 0, and here d dash square minus of minus plus c square p square equal to 0. Now d square is equal to minus p square. This can be written as d square minus p square. Therefore, this implies d square, this can be written as I square into p square. Since I square is equal to minus 1, therefore again this can be written as d is equal to plus or minus I into p. The roots are pair of imaginary. Therefore, the pair of imaginary roots, the roots are pair of imaginary roots. Here also d dash square equal to minus c square p square, that is equal to I square into c square p square, same reason, I square equal to minus 1. Therefore, d dash is equal to plus or minus I into c into p. Therefore, the roots are pair of imaginary roots. Therefore, now solution is, therefore, the solution of the differential equation is x is equal to, since capital X is a dependent variable, small x is independent variable. In the previous case, by mistake, I wrote y. You please make a note. Now, I already corrected there. Now, here also x is equal to, since here roots are complex, alpha value 0, beta value p. Therefore, this can be written as e to the power of 0x into, already we used c3, c4. Next, this can be written as c5 cos beta x, that is px, plus c6 into sin px. This is the solution for the differential equation. When k is negative, and here also we will write, therefore the solution of the differential equation is, now here capital T is the dependent variable, small t is the independent variable. Therefore, this can be written as C5, C6 already used. Here also, alpha value 0, beta value C into P, beta value CP. Cp. Therefore, C7 cos Cpt plus C7 sin Cpt. Substituting the values of x and t in equation number 2 to get the solution in case number 2. Now substituting x and t in equation 2, we get capital Y, small y of x comma t is equal to x is equal to C5 cos P into x plus C6 sine P into x into C7 cos C into Pt plus C8 sin C into Pt. So here C8, which is the solution of one dimensional wave equation when k is a negative. Next, case number 3, when k is a 0. Case 3. When k is 0, the auxiliary equation d square minus k becomes d square minus 0 equal to 0, d dash square minus c square into 0 is equal to 0. D square minus k equal to 0. That is equal to 0, and d dash square minus c square into 0 equal to 0. Therefore, d square equal to 0, d equal to 0 comma 0, d dash square equal to 0, d dash equal to 0 comma 0. The roots are real and equal. Here also the roots are real and equal. Therefore, the solution of the differential equation is x of x is equal to, since we already used arbitrary constant C5, C6, C7 and C8, we use C9 plus C10 of x into e to the power of 0x, into e to the power of 0x, that is 1. So therefore, Now, here, therefore, the solution of the differential equation is capital T is equal to C11 plus C12 of T. Since capital T is the dependent variable and small t is the independent variable. Substituting x and t in equation number 2, we obtain phi of x comma t is equal to C9 plus C10x into C11 plus C12t. This is the solution occurs in case number 3, that is when k is equal to 0. These are the 3 solutions arised for the one dimensional wave equation based on the values of k as positive, negative and 0. So among these 3 solutions, which is the correct solution to find the arbitrary constants by applying the initial and boundary conditions, as we already explained the initial and boundary conditions in the one dimensional wave equation. So which is the suitable solution to find the arbitrary conditions among these 3 solutions arised in case 1, case 2, case 3. Now, the solution occurs in case 2 is considered as suitable solution to find the arbitrary constants by applying the initial and boundary conditions. Why the solution occurs in case 2 is suitable? Because other 2 solutions arised in case 1 and case 3 will fail to give the values of arbitrary constants if we apply the initial and boundary conditions. So equation solution arised in case 2 is the suitable solution that will give the arbitrary values by applying the initial and boundary conditions. Note, in the problems of vibrations of string we always take the following as the correct solution, as the suitable solution. Reason just now I explained, other 2 solutions will fail to give the values of arbitrary constants when we apply the initial and boundary conditions. Now, what is the solution occurs in case 2? That is c5 cos px, c6 sin px, c7 cos cpt plus c8 sin cpt. So I will write c1, c2, c3, c4 instead of c5, c6, c7 and c8 respectively. Or otherwise you may use a, b, c, d instead of c1, c2, c3, c4. Actually, we have to apply the arbitrary conditions. Actually, we have to apply the initial and the boundary conditions in all the solutions occurs in case 1, case 2 and case 3. After that, we will take the suitable solution. But to reduce the length of the solution, we are directly giving the suitable solution as c1 cos px plus c2 sin px, c3 cos cpt plus c4 sin cpt. So to reduce the length of the solution of problems of vibrations of a string, we are giving the suitable solution instead of checking the initial and arbitrary conditions in each case of solution. You please do remember this solution as the correct solution. You directly start the solution of the problems of vibrations of string by considering this solution as the suitable solution to find the arbitrary constant c1, c2, c3 and c4 by applying the initial and boundary conditions.